2. Ziggy. Spring. 2032.
Hey, this is Ziggy Katz. What do I say? Validation word? Seriously, I gotta do a validation word? This whole thing chalks so much. Ugh. Okay, fine. Particles. I'll wait for you. Okay, got it. Just came through. Validation word received. Tulip. Tulip particles, alright? You happy? It's me, I'm not a bot. What do you want me to say? This is my first session, I guess. I mean, I've never been sentenced to counseling before. I'm literally like the last person anyone would expect to be here. I have zero negs, all through school. Zero negs. So, I just want to say first off, this is totally chalky, okay? I guess you probably hear that from everyone, right? I'm innocent, right? Well, I'm not saying I'm innocent, I just think counseling is stupid and does no one any good. I mean, I guess I just don't care what a bot has to say about my precious mental state. My friend Marco had to do counseling last year and he told me all about it. It was after he shut off the appliances in Miss Jenkins' house. She was brimmed too, it was so lift. Marco used to do it to me and I thought it was funny. It's like an obvious reboot too. Miss Jenkins is just so old, she doesn't even know how to reboot her own house. It's like, maybe you should move into universal housing if you can't even reboot your own house. Marco was doing her a favor, in my opinion, showing her the obvious security flaws in her house. He should have gotten pause points, not negs. But instead he had to come to counseling for like 8 sessions, which is like a death sentence. I better not have to come for 8. And Marco had to do this last year when bot counseling was still in beta, so there were like a ton of bugs. Probably should have hacked it like he did the Jenkins. So lift. So Terra lift. And he said how awkward it was, just sitting in this cramped pod talking at a bot. I guess like I'm doing now. Although, I don't feel awkward. I mean, I never really feel awkward. I don't have a CDA like most kids. And I don't take meds. Don't want them. Don't need them. I'm just brimmed. Mainly because I don't think I did anything that needs counseling. I mean, Jackie Farber is a loser. Like, in a very real sense of the word, he's a loser. Like, before they even had the word loser, the dictionary people were like, just staring at a pic of Jackie Farber, and they were inspired to make a new word. Like, wow, this kid Jackie Farber looks like a loser. Oh, really? What's a loser? It's a person who literally exemplifies losing in every possible way. But we already have too many words. We don't have room for another single word. And yet, look at this picture of Jackie Farber. It demands a new word. Our hands are tied. And yeah, I'm sorry for the add-ons, I guess. It's just like, Jackie sits across from me at lunch every day, and it's like, I don't need that neg energy across from me while I eat my packet. It's literally not healthy for me. And he eats so slowly, too. It's like, some of us have places to be. Some of us have songs to write. Jackie just looks down at the ground half the time we're talking. And he's so funny. He'll make a joke, or what he calls jokes, and then he'll be like, Ziggy, do you know why that's funny? And it's like, if it was a lift joke, it should be obvious why it was funny. I shouldn't have to explain your joke. It's just so frown, you know? He's like my dad. It's weird. Why do these people still exist? It's like they're dragging down society, you know? And we all have to share state credit, which is so annoying. So everyone can enjoy their slice of the pie. Rah, rah. My mom's like the worst offender of this. She runs the trauma shelter in town. And she thinks that anyone who makes money is evil. And it's like, no, they're just smart. All right, I know I'm supposed to stay on task. Talk about my transgression. I don't see how this helps. Or like, I don't possibly see what's going to be magically revealed about my psyche that a little blood sample wouldn't show. I eagerly await your report on my mercurial state of mind. Okay, so my transgression. The reason I've been sent here to the netherworld. So, I like to sit outside every day at lunch. It's good for my D intake, which was actually low last week. And also, I like the sun. I'm literally the first person in my family to go outside in the sun. My dad would, like, never let me go outside when I was a kid. If I didn't mention it before, I'll mention it again. My dad is a loser on the scale of Jackie Farber. Anyway, I know I'm not being helpful with these ad-homs, and I'm probably gonna get a neg report for this first inaugural maiden voyage of a counseling session, but whatever. I'm being honest. And I don't even care if it means I have to come for more sessions. Because I'd rather be honest for 8 sessions than lie for 4. I'm always honest, in my life, in my relationships, and in my music especially. So, it's lunch. I take out my packet, and I puncture it, and I'm about to eat it, when Jackie walks up to me and says, hey, Ziggy, do you know why some camels have two humps and others have one? So I'm like, no, and I don't care. And he's like, libido, and he starts laughing like this. Like he just heard his own joke for the first time. And normally I would just tell him to shut up and walk away, but I was sitting with Lila Strzeski. You would never have seen her. She will literally have zero negs for her entire life. And Lila got Tara upset. Like, I think she might have been triggered by Jackie's joke thing. And Jackie has zero sense of other people's feelings. Total low self-monitor. Like, for starters, he didn't even say, hi, Ziggy. Hi, Lila. Can I tell you a joke? He just walked up to us literally while we're puncturing our packets and told a joke about sex. Which isn't allowed anyway, in which I'm pretty sure triggered Lila, even though she would never say it. And I told him, yo, you can't make a joke about sex. And he was just like, it wasn't about sex, it was about desert fauna. And I saw that Lila was really uncomfortable. Her face turned red and her mouth was open, but she wasn't saying anything. She gets triggered real easy, which is part of what makes her so breeze. Like, she knows what she feels and she doesn't deny it, you know? It's why I wanted to sit with her. And she loves my music. Especially Particles of You, but that's another story. And I hated seeing her like that. I mean, I hate when anyone's upset, but especially Lila or whatever. So I stood up and I punched Jackie in the jaw, okay? Am I proud of that? I don't know. I guess I'm supposed to say no to reduce my negs and probably also reduce the amount of sessions I'll have to do here. But I'm all about being honest. Sorry about that. So I'll be honest. Yeah, I am proud. Because Jackie needs to learn about how to deal with other people. Like, throughout civilization, people have probably mainly learned about their behavior through getting punched. Like, back in caveman times, there'd be, like, an annoying caveman, like a guy who draws dicks on cave paintings or whatever, or, like, sneaks up on people while they're hunting buffalo and whispers some frowny joke, like, the plural of buffalo is two buffalo. Basically, like, the Jackie Farber of caveman times. And then some normal caveman, like the me of caveman times, would, like, slug them in the jaw, and they'd stop ruining society. But now we're living in, like, a total police state where you can't invade anyone's personal space or punch them, and so people like Jackie Farber just, like, metastasize because no one ever tells them their behavior totally chocks. And people like me, normal, good people, are forced to be friends with people like him just because I grew up in the house next door and my mom feels, like, Tara bad for him because he can't make any friends. Just like my mom feels bad for everyone in the entire world except me. And you want to know the worst part about this whole thing? Excuse me a sec. Sorry. And you want to know the worst part about this whole thing? It's that Lila was, like, Tara brimmed at me for punching him. Yep, at me. That's the worst thing about this whole day. Like, she turned to me right after I punched Jackie and screamed, Ziggy! And her face was red. I mean, it was already a little red from when she was triggered by the whole camel thing, but now it was, like, bright red. Like, pissed off red. And she looked at me like I was the worst person in the world. And I don't think I'll ever forget her face. Her mouth was open and she had, like, a little string of spit from her top lip to her bottom lip. Like she was about to swallow but got interrupted by how shocked she was that I punched another kid. And her eyes were, like, wet. Not, like, crying wet, but, like, shocked wet. Like, she was too surprised to blink, so there was, like, a backlog of tears. And mostly, I just remember the look of disappointment on her face. Disappointment in me. Like she just discovered something horrible about me. Like, whatever she thought about me a second before was like the complete opposite of what she just realized about me now, you know? And seeing her like that. Seeing that lift face. The face I stare at all day, every day for weeks. Seeing that face looking so disappointed in me made me kind of panic. I didn't know what to say. A million things were racing through my head. And then I said the weirdest thing you can possibly say after punching a person in the face. I said to Lila, my mom runs the trauma shelter downtown. I don't know why I suddenly said that. My brain was scrambled, I think. And I guess if I had to dissect why I said that, it was because I wanted to prove to her that I'm not a bad person. Like, if my mom runs a trauma shelter, I must be a good person too. I know. I'm an idiot. My mom runs the trauma shelter downtown. So stupid. The next minute was kind of a blur. Lila helped Jackie up. Like, they were suddenly in this together. And then she ran off. And Jackie just stared at me. Not brimmed or anything. Just staring. And it reminded me of my dad. Because when dad's angry, he just freezes up and stares at me. Like, Most dads would just be normal and yell at their kids, but my dad just stares. Like, he can't even believe the world didn't work out right. Like, he can't process that anyone would do anything wrong ever. That's how Jackie looked. Like, not brimmed at me, just more confused that I punched him. Weird, right? Anyway, I guess I'm saying that I don't really care about coming to you. My life is so far worse than just coming to the shirky bot counseling. Like, I'd come to counseling for 100 sessions if it meant I could go back and not see Lila's disappointed face. The disappointed string of spit. The disappointed frozen tears in her eyes. The disappointed red face. And the thing that I hate most about it, seeing that face made me love her. I mean, I always really liked her. I mean, I've been thinking about her every day for like 4 weeks, but seeing her today, like that, made me love her. Isn't that so weird? I mean, just at the moment she probably stopped liking me, I started loving her. I guess that's just what I feel most bad about. But I'm not gonna feel bad about Jackie Farber, sorry. I'm just not. Probably saved that kid's life. He should be thanking me. What? What the hell is that? Oh, I'm getting a CM. Ah, it's from you, my new bot friend. End of session. Return Thursday, noon. So that's it? End of session? Okay, well that was easy, I guess. Ziggy Cats, sign out. What was it? Oh, right, particles.